Look, when I look at Homeland Security, there's been a lot of continuity, and I think a lot of the what you've seen in terms of the response that Secretary Napolitano talked about is the investment all of us have made over 10 years and want to continue to make. To me, the real lesson for everybody is the threats are out there. They continue to adapt and change. We have to adapt and change. And we have to remember we're all in it together. You know, when a gunman, whether it's Holmes or Hassan, starts to shoot, he doesn't pick between Republicans and Democrats. He just kills America.
Yeah, that's right.
As far as the biggest homeland security threat right now, a lot of people think it's what we call the lone wolf. Is that your opinion?
I think so. I think people like Holmes, who have clean records, he didn't even have a parking.
He had a speeding ticket.
Oh, he had a speeding
ticket.
Speeding I didn't even know about that. But a lot of these people have clean records, and they be, in the case of the jihad types, they become radicalized on the Internet, something we need to understand better, something I tried to do in my role as chairman of the Intelligence Subcommittee of the Homeland Security Committee in the Congress. But then the civil libertarians say, oh, you can't ask those questions. I think we should ask those questions about everybody, not just about Muslims. We should understand that point where somebody with radical views, which are protected by our Constitution, is prepared to engage in extreme behavior. And that would help us, I think, intercede earlier. But I just want to say something about the Obama administration, which is that its record here is very strong. And the foreign policy record of President Obama, starting with the takedown of Osama bin Laden and starting with a very vigorous pursuit of bad actors around the world, is building on the Bush administration record and I think showing strong results. Where we need to move, either president after this election, is in developing a better narrative for what the United States stands for in the world. I think a lot of people